So when you want to scan a document with a Mac, then this is really easy to do. So all you have to do is you go here to the launchpad, click on that, then you look here under other. There should be the application image capture, and that's what you want to start. And this is the one, the application tells you to scan any documents. So it can be text or it can be pictures. So then you attach your scanner with your USB. You just plug that in like this. And then you make sure your scanner is enabled. Here, this one automatically starts up as soon as I plug it in. And then you see up here in the corner on the devices, there it is. This is my scanner. It's an HP Officejet 6600. And then here on the right side, there you have all kinds of different options. So here right now is selected to use it, the scanner as a flatbed. You can also use the document feeder since this device comes with it. I want to keep it as a flatbed for now. So then you can select if you want to scan text or just black and white or color. And for now I'm going to select text because that's what I'm trying to scan here. And then you can select the resolution. So if you select the lower resolution, then it will be, the scan process will be faster, but the resolution, as it says, it will be lower, so it may be harder to read. If you go higher up, then the scanning will be taking longer, and the image quality will be better, but also will be the file size. So I'm going to keep this at 600 right now. Here under auto selection, we will look at that a little bit later. And then this, if we scan something, we want to save that under pictures for now. And here we can give it a name, say document. And then you can select here under which format you want to save it as. I'm trying to do, let's do a PDF. And then you have image correction here, we do none. So now I have here my example document that I want to use, and I'm going to place it here in the scanner now. So I'm lifting up the lid and I'm going to place this in here, and I'm going to put this right against the edge to make sure that it's here on this side and on here this side to make sure that it's, the document is sitting here straight in there in the scanner. And I'm going to close the lid again. And now back here on the application, I'm going to press overview. And this is going to do a really quick scan. It's just going to take a rough picture of what we're dealing with here. Okay. Here it comes. And now with your mouse you can select the area that you are interested in. So you can just say, oh, I just want this text here. That's all I want the program to scan. So I'm selecting this here. Alright, and then as soon as I've done that, I can click scan and it's going to do this for me. So now this will take a little bit. Okay, so now the scanning process is done, and here we have an extra window that opened up, and it's called the scan results, and here everything that you've scanned, you can just double check if it's right. So, okay, here I open this up as a PDF and everything looks just like the original, so this was really good. So now if I want to scan a picture, then I can do that as well. I just have to make a few adjustments here. So first thing here, I'm going to switch from text to color. Then the resolution here, I'm going to stay the same with 600. That worked pretty well for me in terms of file size and resolution. And here I'm going to just change the name to picture. And then here the format automatically already changed for me to JPEG. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a picture. I can actually take more than one. I'm going to take two pictures in this case, and I'm going to line them up against the edge here to make sure they're straight in there. Slowly closing the lid. I'm going to hit the overview button again. So as you can see, the application already selected two areas here for me. That means as soon as I push the scan button, it's going to create two pictures. It's going to cut them out just as it's selected here. And the application is not always very accurate, so you can, as you can see here, it's cutting the picture, the top part of the picture off. So you can adjust this by clicking on one of these blue dots and then dragging the frame as you need it, like I do here. And then I can do the same thing here. But then there's another specialty here. So you can see this one, this picture here is sideways. So as soon as I'm going to scan this, it's going to save this picture sideways as well. So now there's, in the middle, there's this dot here with this little arm. You can, and you click that and you see this little person here. And that shows you the orientation of how the picture is going to be saved. So if you click on this dot and then you can rotate this, like I do here, and you can rotate it just as you see fit. So here I'm going to rotate it clockwise by 90 degrees. And now it actually, as soon as I scan this, it's going to scan it or save it in the right orientation, which is very useful so that I don't have to do anything later on. Here I'm going to make sure I have it cut out right, like this. So now this looks right. Both of them look right. I'm going to start the scan. This is going to take a little bit. Okay, so now two pictures have been saved, and as you can see, let's open them up and have a look. Okay, this one has a little bit of a corner here. And then the second one, you can see it's been saved in the right orientation. So this worked really well. Okay, so this is it for now. I hope this helped, and don't forget to check out my other YouTube videos.